All right. Good morning, guys. Welcome in Sunday morning trivia. Where's Weber's Mile High cards? Ah, there he is. Weber, my Phillies had their way with your Rockies yesterday afternoon. Hey, Strat. How you doing, man? All right. Good morning, guys. We have 13 questions lined up for you today. Yeah, that's right. 13 questions because, well, I'll get to the because in a little bit when we open this mail here. JJZ popping on here just in time. I've got some mail from JJZ. I got some mail from my buddy Derek, Wicked Discounts. I don't see him here yet. Him and Crosby, I believe, are headed to a show this morning out there in the Pittsburgh area. And some mail from Joester. So we're going to get to this mail, and then we'll open up the trivia for this Sunday morning. Yeah, and if you guys aren't familiar with JJZ, check out this young man. Really is doing a good job with his videos. I'm relatively new to YouTube. I think he's creeping up on 100 already. So great job out of you, JJZ. And I won his 75 subscriber contest. And this is the mail that he sent along. It was for Max Wodell autograph card. He's most recently with the Cincinnati Reds. I believe he's since been released, but I don't know. We'll see if he catches on with another team. It's always, of course, to have a nice autograph card, no matter who it is. And JJZ sent along. No, congrats on. Yeah, it was 75 subscriber. And thank you for your support, Joey, JJZ. So everyone check out JJZ. Oh, awesome. You are over 100 now, 112. That's awesome. So if anybody here isn't familiar with JJZ yet, get over there and check him out. Oh, hidden gem, already subbed you. Thanks. Great job, Raphael. And great job last night. If you haven't already, check out Hidden Gem. He did a really nice job for Scott Spaulding and his daughter. forgive me, I cannot pronounce the condition that she's afflicted with, but yeah, he raised some money for her, and it was a really great cause. So I'm sure if you head over to his page and you haven't done so already, he'd still take a donation. I don't know. He might even have another auction lined up. All right. So also, my buddy Derek, Wicked Discounts. I was in a break of his not too long ago, and the two teams I got, I'll get to those in a minute. And the two teams I got were the Mets and the Arizona Diamondbacks. And I think that led to my distinction as being a D-bag collector. So, Filmington's in here. How you doing, man? So let's see what I got from the break from Wicked Discounts. Put a block on Pepino. Hey, Joe Mansman, how you doing? Waxman, good morning. I don't know if I need more D-backs cards, Waxman, but of course I appreciate anything sent my way. All right, so in the break with Wicked, out of the optic, I got a Dominic Smith and a Jacob DeGrom. Another Jacob DeGrom and a pink Jacob DeGrom. Ahmed Rosario, kind of off to a slow start with the Mets, but he was a real second half player last year in his rookie year. So we'll see what he does in the second half. Jacob DeGrom and Michael Conforto. Just as Michael Conforto was starting to get hot with a couple home runs, he got a concussion, so he's out for a week. I know that because I have him in fantasy. Dominic Smith again, another Michael Conforto. Noah Syndergaard, Diamond Kings. And a pink, another Ahmed Rosario, another Syndergaard. That does it for the Mets. Now my D-bag collection. Garrison Parkhurst, good morning. Hey, field guy. Paul Goldschmidt. So there are some good, well, only a good player in this year's Diamondback team, but you know, next year's set, there's really no one of note on their team now. Zach Greinke's still there, but I think his days are numbered. On the D-backs, Paul Goldschmidt, there's a Zach Greinke right there. Another Goldschmidt and Greinke. And another Goldschmidt and Greinke. As I said, the only real two players of note on the D-backs. All right, and now this is why we have 13 questions this morning, along with my 10 that I have the usual lined up. Wicked Discounts donated 3 hits to the channel, so I'm going to go 13 strong this morning. He said use these for the giveaway, and that's just what I'm going to do. So we have a on-card auto here of Milwaukee prospect Cody Medeiros. A Jordan Bell out of last year's Panini autograph, the Golden State Warriors. And now, see, this is one I have a problem with. This is since I'm a newly anointed D-bag collector, this is a Zach Greinke patch card. So you know what? I'm going to have to keep that one, but I will substitute out of Immaculate, a Willie Adames serial number to 99 patch card. So these 3 cards are going to be courtesy of Wicked Discounts, the last 3 questions in the morning. So I'll put those aside for later in the stream. And I have one more piece of mail to get to, and that is from my buddy Joester. Everybody knows Joester. Hey, Mark from Kentucky. Yes, I think you are the preeminent Willie Adames collector on YouTube. He's not having a bad season by any means. Weber's, yeah, the Phillies and Rockies this afternoon, 1:05 my time, 11:05 local time for you. I don't know. Who takes the hill today, Weber's? I haven't looked at the pitching matchups this afternoon. I know Aaron Nola had 12 strikeouts in 6 innings yesterday, leading the Phillies over the Rockies, which was really impressive because Nola has – had his struggles of late, but he got it together yesterday. Yeah, he was filthy. All right, so my buddy Joester, everybody's buddy is Joester. He supports just about everyone on YouTube. Awesome, awesome guy. And Joester looks like he added to my D-bag collection. I have some Archie Bradley, who's actually a really good relief pitcher with the D-backs. Another Archie Bradley, added Gypsy Queen. Patrick Corbin, of course, he's no longer there. He's having a really good year after signing the big contract with the Nationals. Another Patrick Corbin. Who else we have here? I didn't see join. Troy from Troy's Cards, Cards, and Comics and Autographs. Thanks for joining in here. And there's Sports Kids. Sports Kids becoming a regular here on Sunday morning. And awesome. Yeah, Rookie Monster. Joester is the man. Thanks for hopping on here with me. And BRC, Lord have mercy. What's going on, my man? All right, we have a Daniel Descalso, a Brandon Drury. Eduardo Escobar, Goldie, Paul Goldschmidt. That's probably my favorite subset from last year's The Legends of the Macon. They have some really cool, really nice subset. Bradley Moore, thanks for jumping on here. Sports Kids asks, do we have older player questions today? Actually, I think it's a pretty good mix, Sports Kids. I would say probably about half and half. Probably about half and half. Hey, William Schneider, thanks for stopping by, man. What's my team? Well, I'm local. I don't really have a huge rooting interest in any team, but I am a local to the Philadelphia Phillies, so I do PC them to an extent. Really cool Paul Goldschmidt Diamond Kings card. Always liked the Diamond Kings as a kid. Another Goldie. Zach Greinke, who's off to a really good start this season, just came down with a pulled lat in his last start, but the MRI came back negative. It's another Goldie, a Greinke. As you can see, most of your D-bag cards are going to be Greinke and Goldie, as they're the only two players of note on Arizona last year. Another Greinke out of Gypsy Queen. Zach Godley. Zach Godley autograph card went out on trivia a couple weeks ago. Jake Lamb has really struggled since his rookie season. Another Jake Lamb. Brandon McCarthy's jumped around to a bunch of teams. David Peralta, really good hitter on the Diamondbacks this year. A converted pitcher to an outfielder. John Duplantier. He's in the middle relief role right now, so maybe they will move him into the rotation, which could behoove him. A.J. Pollock, of course, with the Dodgers now. A Fernando Rodney, well-traveled closer. Robbie Ray, I expect him to get moved somewhere towards the deadline this year. Jack Reinheimer, rookie. And older Tops, that looks like a 99 Tops, Todd Stottlemyre. Yeah, John Ryan Murphy did have a power surge last year. The former Yankee farmhand. Actually played a little bit for the Yankees, too. I have one of his autographs cards that will make an appearance here on Sunday Morning Trivia coming up. This is another cool Legends of the Making card, Justin Upton. Resident Master on everything Diamondback. Yeah, unfortunately, I think I've been anointed that title, huh, Waxman? Margo Vargas, Taiwan Walker, my buddy Filmington, not happy with Taiwan Walker. He invested quite a few dollars into Taiwan Walker, and he's been a bit of a flop, but hey, you win some, you lose some. I know he's won on plenty as well, like the sick Tyler Glass now to 10 autograph that he has. Rookie card. Eric Young and Chris Young. All right, so thank you to Joester for those. And that's going to bring us to our trivia. And once again, for the third week in a row, I just lost my chat. So just give me a minute, and I'm going to have to refresh this. All right, there we go. I got my chat back, and we are ready to roll with the trivia for this morning. Again, we got the normal 10 questions ready to roll out, and then we're going to have three bonus questions courtesy of Wicked Derek over there at Wicked Discounts. So the 10 cards that we have going out prior to the three bonus questions. We have five autograph cards. Mac Williamson of the San Francisco Giants. This is out of Topps Chrome. Sam Coonrod out of 18 Chrome. This is a Bowman's first. Currently pitching in AAA for San Francisco. A Daniel Alvarez autograph. Minor leaguer now with the Baltimore Orioles. Brian Ellington, he was up last year for the Marlins for a while, a flamethrower, but he just had trouble with his control. Field guy, cool. He sent me the email from last week. Awesome. So, I have a envelope waiting to go out to you. So, Brian Ellington autograph out of Optic. That's his rated rookie auto. And the Andrew Stevenson out of Topps Chrome. 2018 going out this morning. So that'll do it. That's the five autographs that's going out. I have a couple vintage here. We got going out. We have, this is a 1974 Topps All-Star card with Dick Allen and Hank Aaron. We have 1972 Topps Tom Seaver. This was a Boyhood Photo of the Stars card. A really cool card out of Tom Seaver. And it's well-centered in pretty good condition. And then we have three more current cards. We have out of Topps Fire, Aaron Judge, who is hopefully going to be back soon for the Yankees. Aaron Judge, I know we always have a lot of Yankee fans out there. Shohei Ohtani, who just hit a bomb last night. His second home run already after just rejoining the roster last week. So we have a Shohei Ohtani rookie card, rookie debut card out of 2018 Topps. And a really cool Bowman's Best rookie card for Vladimir Guerrero. Vladdy off to a bit of a slow start, but I don't think there's anything to worry about there. The guy's just got too much talent. All right, so we're going to mix these up and get started. Sunday morning trivia. Again, I appreciate everyone jumping on here, spending some time. Get one final mix. All right, and we're ready to go. So first card of the morning, first is going to be the autograph. On-card auto of Brian Ellington, rated rookie of Optic for the Miami Marlins. Rule. BRC, you know, I just as I saw that pop up, I remember. Yes, because I think the last 2 weeks I hit the rules after the first question. So thanks for being on top of that for me, brother. Awesome video again last night. That you upload. I think you uploaded it yesterday. It really sounded like you were getting hit with a typhoon, the amount of rain that was coming down on in the background of that video you put up, BRC. Yeah, you guys should check that out. Hey, Danny and Grace, thanks for stopping by, man. Appreciate it. Brandon Boss is here. Didn't see you pop in here. I do have some Tiger. I tell you what, Boss, if you win a card and you'd like to substitute a Tiger Woods card for the winning card, I will happily do so. Of course, you see a couple Brooks Koepka cards in the background as he's just absolutely annihilating the field in this year's second major of the year in golf, the PGA up there in Bethpage Black. Just 12 under par, 7 shots clear of the field heading into the final round. And his cards are just absolutely going nuts on eBay right now. All right, so the rules before we get started here. Number one, of course, be a subscriber. Number two, no purchase or payment necessary. All prizes go to winners free of charge. Winners must email their shipping info with me. I ask within 48 hours, please, and this only applies to first-time winners. My email address has been attached in the description below. Correct answers are subject to my live chat scroll, because you know if you have some lag, your chat scroll might show up a little different than mine. I know Mr. Eric Jabs has started doing some trivia at the end of his Fan Mail Friday, and he's had a big issue with this as well. So usually this doesn't come into play, but sometimes it does, and when it does, I have to go by the scroll that pops up on my feed. Prizes are non-transferable, please. And this is just for my own sanity, because it can get confusing having this card go to this person, this one, this one. So if for any reason you don't want the card, just let me know and I'll throw it into the bin to be given away at a later date. And of course, the last rule, just have fun. That's what we're here for on Sunday morning for probably about a half hour or so, maybe 45 minutes this morning. All right, so without further ado, let's get started. For the Brian Ellington autograph card out of Don Russ Optic. JJZ, no football. You know, I'm thinking maybe once football season rolls around, I will mix in some football and football cards, but I have not decided yet on that. All right, so question number one in the morning for the Brian Ellington. Name the only pitcher to win the Cy Young Award in one league after starting the season in the other league. Name the one pitcher to win the Cy Young Award in one league after starting the season in another league. And I will give you a hint. This is an early 80s pitcher. We have Seaver, Scherzer, Moyer, Sabathia, Verlander, Pedro. I don't know. Holiday, Scherzer, Maddox, Sale, Johnson, Price, Clemens, Ryan, Negro, Ryan, Clemens, Negro, Hunter, Glavin, Ryan, Seaver, Jack Morris, Ryan, Willis. Looks like I might have to give another hint here. Dontrell, Negro, Carlton, Tudor, Sutcliffe. Mark from Kentucky. Yes, sir, Mark. Yes, Rick Sutcliffe. Rick Sutcliffe started the 1984 season with the Cleveland Indians and was traded to the Cubs where he won the Cy Young Award, leading the Cubs to the NL East title. Awesome job out of Mark from Kentucky. First, I appreciate you joining us here on trivia, and great job with the answer there. So let me mark that one down for Mark from Kentucky. I think a lot of us are familiar with Mark from KY's videos. Check them out. He's been doing videos for a while, and every single one of them are awesome. He's one of the bigger prospectors here on YouTube. Really goes after those young players. So the Brian Ellington's going out to Mark from Kentucky. A baseball card collector says he really likes that Judge, so make it Googleable. Let's see here. Baseball card collector is one heck of a really fast on the keyboard. So I don't know if this one's Googleable or not, baseball card collector, but we'll see. Oh, by the way, Alex, I have emailed Jabs about the trivia questions that I want from him, and then as soon as I receive them, I will send them on to you. All right, BRC, thanks for jumping on here for a little while, man. I appreciate it. All right, so for the Aaron Judge Topps Fire card. Oh, no problem. You got it, man. All right. So for the question number two for the Judge Topps Fire card, what future Hall of Famer was born on the day Bobby Thompson hit his shot heard round the world in 1951? What future Hall of Famer was born on the day Bobby Thompson hit his shot heard round the world? We got Pujols. Well, Pujols is still playing, so he's certainly not in the hall yet. We got Jader. Field guy right away with the Dave Winfield. Field guy 316. Awesome, man. Yeah, Dave Winfield was born on that day. And, of course, that was shot heard around the world as one of the most famous home runs in Major League Baseball history. So, Field Guy had a big win last week and a big win again this week. Dave Winfield, of course, came up with the Padres and later had some great, great years with the Yankees. All right, Field Guy. Congrats on that one. Drafted in all sports. Yeah, Dave Moger. I think, he was a really good, I want to say volleyball player as well. He was really one heck of an athlete. All right, so the next we have, let's move that, shuffle that around a little bit. We have a Mack Williamson, big power hitter for the Giants. I believe he's coming off the bench for him right now. Big power hitter for the Giants out of Topps Chrome. Hey, Thrice Aroni. Check out Thrice Aroni's videos too. Always entertaining. All right, number three question on the morning for the Williamson Auto. Who was the first player to get 240 hits in a season after World War II? Who was the first player to get 240 hits in a season after World War II? You don't have to go back to, like earlier in the century. I would say 30 years ago. We have Altuve, Ted Williams, Wade Boggs. Raider Nation, Wade Boggs. Yes. Raider Nation, he won a couple cards a couple weeks ago, and he gets back on the board this week. Wade Boggs in 1985 had 240 hits with the Red Sox. This was the first time in 55 years that any player had reached that milestone. So Raider Nation picks up the Mack Williamson auto, and being a Raiders fan, that might be a card for you as well. Of course, the San Francisco Giants. So hopefully the Giants are a team at UPC, and that Mac Williamson auto right out to you. Thanks, Dave. Yeah, you know, it's it really does. I'd say it probably takes me an hour to come up with these questions. So I do put a little bit of work into it, because, you know, you want to find that mix where they're not impossible, yet, you know, it's can't get it right off the bat. So, all right. So that's going to bring us to question number four, which is this really nice looking 1972 Topps for you vintage fans out there. Tom Seaver card, 1972 Topps. Look at it. The camera wants to focus, really doesn't want to focus. But nevertheless, 1972 Topps, Tom Seaver. Question number four. What Oakland A's player went to arbitration and was found to have an invalid contract in 1974? What Oakland A's player went to arbitration and was found to have an invalid contract in 1984? We got Ricky Henderson. We got Reggie Eckersley, Rudy Jackson, Canseco, Rudy Hunter, Rick Osborne, Hunter. Yes. Rick Osborne is correct. Catfish Hunter. This arbitration released the A's number one pitcher from Charles Finley. Of course, Finley was the owner, and he was unwilling to give his player raises and sold them and traded them to other teams just to show his power. And this was really the beginning of the demise for the A's that won three consecutive World Series. So Rick Osborne, I know Rick is certainly not a first-time winner. He's won a few of these in the past, so awesome job out of Rick Osborne. All right. Yeah, Catfish, of course, went on to have in the late 70s a whole bunch of good years with the Yankees, of course, obviously, as did Reggie Jackson. Hidden Gems, as a lot of us know, a big football guy, but he's on here this morning. He says he's learning a little bit on the baseball end. All right, so that brings us to question number, where are we? Question number five for the Vladimir Guerrero Bowman's Best auto. SportsKiz says he can get it for free at his LCS, but nothing's better than free, is it, SportsKiz? All right, so question number five for the Vladdy Guerrero out of Bowman's Best. We do have some more autos coming up. We have three more autos coming up. All right, for the Vladimir Guerrero Bowman's Best, what LA Dodger was the first to ever hit 30 home runs and have 100 RBIs in a season 3 years in a row? Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say auto? Okay. What Dodgers the first to accomplish that 3 years in a row? We got Kofa, Yagerse, Piazza, Harvey, Gibson, Snyder, Strawberry, Campanella, Garvey, Gonzalez, Garvey, Robinson, Harvey, Pizza, Smith, Piazza, Turner, Guerrero, Dusty Baker, Piazza, Jackie, Gonzalez, Kirk Gibson, Eric, Sam Burnett, didn't even see you slide in here, but I appreciate you joining, and yes, that is the correct answer. Sam Burnett has Eric Karros. Yeah, Eric Karros did this from 1995 to 1997. I think now he is an analyst. Is it Fox Sports that he's with? I do see him on the TV every once in a while. I believe it's Fox that he's with. So, Sam Burnett, great job, man. I appreciate you jumping on here and coming away with a win. I believe that is your first win here on Trivia Morning, so you'll need to shoot me an email with your info. Sam Burnett. All right. Vladdy Jr. Bowman. Bowman's Best to Sam Burnett. Oh, I appreciate that, Thrice. I always forget to ask. But, yeah, that's appreciated. Everyone hits that thumbs up button for me. Would be awesome. Thank you very much, Thrice Aroni. All right, so that leads us up to question number six. Question number six, as we're almost at the halfway mark here, is for a Daniel Alvarez out of Donruss Signature Series. Panini, 2016 Panini, Daniel Alvarez auto. Who was the first pitcher to strike out 100 batters in a season for 20 consecutive seasons? Who was the first pitcher to K 100 batters in a season 20 consecutive seasons in a row? We got Scherzer, Cy Young, Ryan, Moyer, Nolan, Seaver, Maddox, Ryan. Ryan, Smoltz, Seaver, Ryan, Young, Ryan, Johnson, Sosa, Glavin, Walter Johnson, Ryan, Walter Johnson, Gibson, Glavin, Clemens. Ohtani, he just might. Dude is just ultra talented. Christy Mathewson, Ford, Carlton, Lee Smith, Gibson, Moyer, Feller. Randy Johnson, Lefty Grove. I seem to have you guys stumped on this one. Carlton, Negro. Unit, Randy Johnson. All right, so this is, give a hint here. We got Fergie Jenkins, Morris Gibson, Franco, Cologne, Hershiser. This is a Hall of Famer. This is a Hall of Famer who some people might consider him a compiler, because, you know, he didn't have any great standout seasons, but he was very good for a very long time. We have Hershiser, Hunter, Jack Morris, Ryan, Hurt, Eckersley, Kilroy, Koufax, Rodney, Marichal, Cy Young, Huff, Venezuela, Seaver, Cott, Blylevin. Blylevin's a good guess. He had some huge strikeout total years. Perry, Mathewson, Nickel, Glavin, Negro, Hunter, Shinnings, Saberhagen, Tommy John. You guys are dancing all around it, I tell you that. With the Phil Negro to David Wells, Jenkinson, Sewell, Morris, Halliday, Sutcliffe, Martinez, Stargell. Boy, see, I'm going to have to give another hint. All right, this guy, he pitched for, let's see, I'm trying to think of a couple teams he pitched for. He pitched for the Angels and the Dodgers. Dennis, Fingers, Wood, Fox, Bedrosian, Negro, Kraft, Blylevin, Saberhagen, Gaylord, Bunning, Maddox. All right, I'm going to have to give you a really Monday Night Mikey. Yes, Don Sutton. I was going to give the final clue, which was he's an Atlanta Braves broadcaster. All right, Monday Night Mikey. Awesome job out of you. Monday Night Mikey. The Daniel Alvarez auto. All right. Lone Star Legends, thanks for popping on here, man. Paul Dyche, it's Don Sutton. Just a little bit after the fact. Paul, it's been a few weeks since you've been on the winner board here. All right, so we have question number seven coming up for a Hank Aaron Dick Allen All-Star card from 1974. Dick Allen, Hank Aaron auto card. Nice little vintage card here if you're a Braves fan. Filmington, are you auctioning off your wrench? Is that what's going on here? How you doing, Pepino? All right. Question number seven as I move along to the second sheet here. The great Christy Mathewson retired with 373 career wins. How many of those wins were with the Giants? Out of Christy Mathewson's 373 wins, How many of them came with the Giants? Rookie Monster says 373, 172, 225, 372. Garrett Torres. Yes, 372. Let me write down that name real fast because I don't think I've seen you in here before, Garrett Torres, but I appreciate you jumping on here. Garrett Torres. Garrett, you're going to need to send me an email, and we'll get this card out to you. Thanks for joining us here. Yeah, Christy Mathewson had one win with the Cincinnati Reds. All the other ones, of course, came with the Giants. So I did not know that. I looked that one up, and I just really thought that was interesting. So, and Rookie Mons knows trade. That's why you guessed all 373. Shaq Rat was on 372 as well, just a little bit later. If anyone hasn't checked out Robert P's videos, he's just started uploading videos. So be sure to check out Robert P, Robert Shaq Rat. All right, so that card's going to go out to Garrett Torres. And that's going to come up. That's going to bring us up to question number 8, which is going to be for the Sam Coonrod, Bowman's first Bowman out of Bowman Chrome, 2018. Phil says he likes that name. It does add a bit of shine to it too. Try to angle it in a way where it doesn't blind you guys. Coops Cards, come on, you have to get on the board here with a win today. All right, number eight. In 2001, Roger Clemens won the Cy Young Award. What starting pitcher had better stats in 10 different categories but was still passed up for the Cy Young as they voted for Roger Clemens? What pitcher had better stats in 10 different categories yet counting stats, yet still the award went to Roger Clemens? We got Kerry Wood, Pedro, Ryan, Pedro, Maddox, Johnson, Pettit, Smoltz, Maddox, Schilling, Cliff Lee, John Garland. You're close, Philminson. John Garland had a really good year, I believe, the following year. Ryan, Johnson, Glavin, Barry Bonds, Randy Johnson, West, Gooden. Mark Mulder. Card hobbyist. Yes, the card hobbyist. Mark Mulder. Mark Mulder of the A's tops Roger Clemens in the following categories, but still did not get the award. He had 21 wins, Clemens 20. His ERA was better, 345 to 351. He pitched 9 more innings pitched. He had 4 shutouts to Clemens 0. He had 6 complete games to Clemens 0. He had 17 quality starts as opposed to Clemens' 12. His base runners per 9 were better. His walks per 9. His wins after loss. I mean, Clemens had a great season, but he definitely won that award on reputation alone, which is why a lot of times the awards are a little bit bogus in my estimation. But nevertheless, card hobbyist, awesome job. Awesome job on that win. Card hobbyist. I don't remember. I know you've been in my streams before. I'm not sure if that's your first win. If it is, of course, just shoot me that email and get that card out to you. I'll probably be shipping out on Tuesday or Wednesday this week. Bradley Moore, you had the win. You had the answer, but you got to hit that refresh button, brother. You got to hit that refresh. Mark from Kentucky, he got robbed. I mean, he's not the only player to ever deserve an award and not get it. And of course, don't even get me started in the Hall of Fame votes and that whole ridiculousness. Sports kids just missed out. All right, Shohei Ohtani, rookie debut card out of 18, tops. Shohei Ohtani, nice little $3 or $4 card here. Shohei Ohtani, rookie. Question number 9. Grover Cleveland Alexander is one of only two Philadelphia Philly pitchers to strike out 200 or more batters and hold opponents to a batting average of less than 200 in a season. Who is the other? Who is the other great Philly pitcher? We have Halliday, Carlton, Hamels, Schilling, Cliff Lee, Tupac Shakur. That's a good guess. Not really. Lee, Halliday, Lee, Schilling, Button. I think that's supposed to be Pat Burrell. Airtime is, I'm a roller coaster guy and love the airtime, Hidden Gem. That's the first time I've actually been asked that. Roberts, Schmidt, Longboard, Nola, Big Country's Wheelhouse. That's right. Aaron Nola, Big Country Wheelhouse, did not have to go far for the answer for that question. Aaron Nola did that just last year, 2018. Awesome job out of you, Big Country's Wheelhouse. And I do believe that is your first win here on Sunday Morning Trivia. You're just going to need to shoot me an email. The information is below in the description. And I'll get that Shohei Ohtani out to you, Big Country. Doesn't get more recent than a trivia question than that. Just last year, Aaron Nola. Of course, Aaron Nola had a fantastic game yesterday, getting back on track against the Colorado Rockies. All right, this is going to be the number 10 question of the morning here, and then we're going to have three bonus questions courtesy of Wicked Discounts. Wicked Discounts is not with us this morning because he is off at a card show just outside of Pittsburgh with Evgeny Crosby, hopefully getting some good buys, and I'm sure we'll see on a video soon with what he picked up there. Weber says boo. You know what, Weber? I believe it was the seventh inning where the Rockies started off the inning with back-to-back doubles to cut the lead to 2-1, but they had the contact play where they could have tied it up, and it was hit right to third baseman Mikel Franco to preserve the lead for the Phillies. Not sure he should have ran tried to score on that play, but nevertheless, I digress. All right, number 10 question on the morning is for this Andrew Stevenson autographed rookie card out of Topps Chrome. Number 10 question is for the Andrew Stevenson Topps Chrome. Yes, I digress and Pepino digests. Number 10 question, in 2018, just last year, who did Justin Verlander strike out for his 2,500th career strikeout when he became the 33rd pitcher in Major League Baseball history to reach this milestone? Who did Verlander strike out for number 2,500? I will give a hint. He's a big name. He's a big, big name. We got Scherzer, Yelich, Harper, Pujols, Buxton, Acuna, Chris Davis, Joey Gallo, Chris Davis, Betts, Trout, Bellinger, Judge, Ohtani, baseball card collector, Shohei Ohtani, baseball card collector, gets back in the winner's circle. Baseball card collector used to dominate this competition. And he's back in the winner's circle here. Yeah, Shohei Ohtani was Verlander's 2,500th strikeout. It's very interesting. Baseball card collector. I'm not sure if you Googled that or not, because you came up with that one pretty much short order. Baseball card collector. It's the Andrew Stevenson Topps Chrome Auto rookie card. All right, so that's going to do it for my questions on the day. But as you saw in the mail day earlier, I got three. He needs to get back what he's doing. I got three questions courtesy of Wicked Discounts. I think a lot of us are familiar with Wicked Discounts. If you're not, of course, get over there and check out his channel. We got a Jordan Bell. I don't usually give away much basketball here, but he sent along a pretty cool autograph out of 2000. 2017 and 18 Panini, the World Champion Warriors Jordan Bell autograph card. A autograph card of Cody Medeiros, a youngster in the Milwaukee Brewers organization. And a Willie Adames Immaculate Patch card. I had to substitute this in as I took out a patch card of Zach Greinke that I am, apparently I'm now PCing. So I kept that, and I'm going to substitute that Immaculate card. All right. Coop says he loves Adames. He is a very, very talented player. He reminds a lot of people of Derek Jeter and just his build, the way he hits the ball. So if he has half the career that Jeter had, that will be a very successful career. All right, so question number 11. Question number 11 in bonus trivia here is for the Jordan Bell autograph card from the war. Filmington reportedly has it any, guys. That's right, you heard that here first. Pepino Man breaks the news. Breaking news. Filmington has an innie. I think that's very fairly common, though. Wouldn't the Audi be less common? I don't know. D's card break is creeping on in here. Thanks for watching, D's. Your support's always appreciated. Question number 11. Question number 11, courtesy Wicked Discounts. What former Indiana Hoosier catcher was drafted by the Chicago Cubs in the first round, fourth overall in the 2014 Major League Draft? What former Indiana Hoosier catcher was drafted by the Cubs? Sports Kids says Piazza. Mark from Kentucky says Schwaber. I will not deduct points for misspelling because that is the correct answer. Mark from KY, Kyle Schwarber, yeah. Kyle Schwarber was a huge hitting Cubs. Was a huge hitting catcher for the Cubs at the University of Indiana. He was also one heck of a football player back in high school as well. So Mark from KY with his second win of the morning. Awesome job out of you, Mark. From KY, I'm not sure if you're a basketball collector or not, but we'll throw that in there to go along with your earlier winning. Yeah, Kyle Schwarber, he does look like a football player. He had some wheels on him, too. I saw some highlights of him in high school. I don't know if he played halfback, but, man, he'd get he'd just run through some tackles. All right, Raphael, thanks for stopping in here, man. Appreciate it. You have a blessed one as well. All right, question number 12 on the morning for the Cody Medeiros Milwaukee Brewer farmhand autograph card here. Question number 12. In 1996, what left-handed pitcher... And I'm doing this for Wicked Discounts. So this is one of Wicked Discounts' favorite players. So if you're familiar with his channel, you have inside information on this question. In 1996, what left-handed pitcher and someone he PCs recorded the 100th and final win of his career, a complete game shutout against the Padres? We got Stargell, Perry, Glavin, Randy Johnson, Jimmy Key, Chris Archer, Glasnow, Archer, Candelaria, Smiley, the card hobbyist, Zane Smith. Yes, card hobbyist, Zane Smith. Zane Smith finished his career with an even 100 wins against 115 losses. So I'm interested to know, card hobbyist, did you know that the Wicked PCs Zane Smith, or did you know that Zane just happened to know that he had 100 career wins on the button? So card hobbyist with his second win of the morning. Awesome job out of you. And that's going to bring us to our final in-out. All right. Yeah, he is a Zane Smith fanatic. He might be the only one. So let's make him the president of that fan club, as he might be the only one. All right, so that's going to bring us to our final question of the morning. And it's going to be for his really, really, really nice, immaculate patch card, serial number 99 of Willie Domus, courtesy of Wicked Discounts. All right, good luck to everyone. Good luck to Mark from Kentucky, big Domus fan. Question number 13 and final question of the morning. Former Major League pitcher Mike Marshall, who pitched for 9 different teams in his career, and this former Pittsburgh Pirate are the only two pitchers in baseball history to appear in 90 or more games 3 times. Who is the other pitcher besides Marshall to appear in 90 games 3 separate times in 3 different seasons? Glavin, Kiner, Hunt, Bonds, Doc Ellis, Ollie Perez, Stargell, Candelario, Gusby, Melanson. Remember, if he pitched in 90 or more games, he's a relief pitcher. So think of an old venerable relief pitcher who just appeared in a lot of ball games for the Pirates, among other teams. We have Melanson, Wilhelm, Tommy John, Blylove, and Torres. Teakwood, Rick Osborne with his second win of the morning. Yeah, Rick Osborne. Kent Tekulve, the otherwise known as Teakwood, the submariner. He also pitched for the Phillies. And I watched him many games in the late 80s, the vet pitching for the Phillies. And the Cincinnati Reds as well. So, awesome job, Rick Osborne, for your second win of the morning. So, the last 3 questions were all second-time winners of the morning. So, that's cool. Rick Osborne will get that out to you Tuesday or Wednesday for sure. All right, that's going to do it. Filmington, you really had to Google that. You know, I really thought you would have been in on that. That wasn't a... Too difficult of a question. I don't think that was a Google question. Just thought someone would have that one right offhand. It's Pino. What's the consolation prize? You know what, Pino? I do. I think I have your address. I am going to have to send you something. Always keeping us entertained here in the morning. All right, so that's it, guys. For any of you golf fans out there, enjoy that. The PGA Championship this afternoon, and watch Brooke Koepka bring it home as he's just crushing the field. I believe he tees off at 2:30 or so. So, yeah, that's going to do it for trivia. Bradley Moore says, let's get some Danica questions in there. Now, I don't know if I have any Danica questions. Maybe I could have some Danica cards I could show off for sure. As you do know, I PC Danica Patrick. Quite possibly the most, I don't want to exaggerate. One half of a NASCAR driver and Formula One driver. Let's leave it at that. All right, everyone, I really appreciate you stopping by, spending some time with me. It means a lot. Couldn't do it without you. So everyone have a great week. I look forward to seeing all of you again next week. So until then, YouTube, thanks for joining me and have a great, great day.